You can't just create a strategy. You have to get employees to do it. So how do we get employees to buy into it? How aligned can you get you, your leadership, and all your employees around who are we, what are we trying to achieve, and how are we going to get there?
Branding, as we'll learn today, it's not just a marketing discipline. Branding is a people and a process discipline. It's a strategy to help differentiate your company so ultimately you can outbehave your competition.
Greg is an unforgettable expert who provides the path to creating high-performance work cultures and sustainable results.
The Outbehaving the Competition program from Brand Integrity is the first program I've taken 9 pages of notes on in 2 years.
A promise is a promise. If you break it, it's a lie. Now think about the marketing activity that you see in your organization. Think about the marketing activity you see in some of the companies that you do business with. If you're simply making promises that your people are not empowered and engaged and inspired to keep, you're lying.
As the founder of Brand Integrity, Greg works with many of today's leading companies to define and execute performance-based strategies that drive culture transformation.
Brand Integrity is a philosophy, it's a journey, it's a destination. You achieve Brand Integrity when you are who and what you say you are, and you're achieving the business results that you're looking for in your organization. I went and spoke at a telecommunications conference. I brought with me an article from the newspaper that day where a telecommunications firm had actually won an award for having less customer complaints. That was the award they give in that industry, of less customer complaints. And someone raised their hand and said, hey, that ties into my company's tagline, we suck less. They're winning with that. We're not going to be great at customer service, but we're going to be better than those other guys. We're going to upset you just a few less times.
Greg's insights are documented in his book, Achieve Brand Integrity, 10 Truths You Must Know to Enhance Employee Performance and Increase Company Profits. Winner of the 2008 Axiom Best Business Book Awards. And that celebrates innovative, intelligent, and creative books that make us think, see, and work differently every day.
I thought Greg's presentation was fantastic. I think that what he really does is empowers companies and organizations to really make the most of the limited resources that most of us have to work with, and certainly really helps us to empower people, which is the core of everything we do. So, I think there's things like strategic planning and things like really recognizing positive behaviors in your employees is just a huge plus. And I learned a tremendous amount from listening to Greg.
We meet companies all day long. I see organizational leaders all day long that said, oh, we're on our 10th version of this in the last decade. Every year we have a retreat and we see if we need to tinker with our mission statement or our values or our cultural principles. And then we do our strategic plan, or we have a 3-year plan or a 5-year plan. The problem is, a recent study shows that 31% of employees in America could actually admit that they understood what the mission was of the organization and how it applied to their job. 31%. Almost 70% of workers don't really get the mission and how they do it every day. That's fairly pathetic, is it not?
Absolutely.
It's pathetic, 31%, that's absolutely ridiculous. Even worse than that is there's that same study, which was done with tens of thousands of employees, showed that only 19% actually knew what the top priorities were and were committed to them. So the missing ingredient are what we call the how factors. You have to define behaviors. So again, you can't just say we're going to outperform the competition. You have to behave better than the competition. Anyone ever flown JetBlue or Southwest? Anyone? Anyone? A pretty good experience, right? Southwest, come here?
Yeah.
Southwest, I landed on a plane at Southwest Airlines, and we landed, and they were going taxiing to the gate, and the pilot said, hey, folks, everybody look out the window to the right. See the Delta plane going by? Everybody wave, show them what a full flight looks like. It's that kind of humor that they use that's trained. The expectation is set that you have to be funny. We hire funny people. They communicate how important it is to have jokes on every flight. And people are held accountable for whether or not they're actually doing it. After you have your brand concepts, you can't stop there. The next most important piece is to understand what our beliefs are behind it. So every single employee comes to your organization, whether it's a volunteer or an employee, they have their own belief systems. You all have your own beliefs. You walked in here, I don't know what you believe. They're totally invisible, but they drive your attitudes. The best companies define what our beliefs are. They define it. They say, look, this is what we believe about delivering world-class service. If we hire Jane and Bob, and Jane and Bob have different beliefs, then they shouldn't work in this organization unless they can adopt those beliefs and get comfortable with them. Because the beliefs drive the behaviors. With employees, if you have the behaviors defined, it's like the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. Because now you have behaviors, so you can hold people accountable. And even better than that, they can hold themselves accountable.
I found Greg's information to be a lot of fun, very unique, and a new way of looking at things. We spend a lot of time in our industries looking at brand and brand identity, but we never relate it back to how we're really going to implement it.
Motivating employees, it takes a lot more than heart. Just because you put up a poster that says teamwork doesn't mean that your employees are going to do teamwork. Think about it. If you're recognizing people as part of your work process for doing the company strategy, then shouldn't just about everybody that works in your organization be getting recognized occasionally? Even if you said, wow, maybe the goal is one nomination per year per person, and you got 150 people, it's 150 captured successes. Now, one of the questions that typically comes flying out at this point is, well, what if they're just doing their job? Right? You don't want to make a big deal about that. That's what we pay them for. That's what we train them for. Or we brought them in as a volunteer. They're supposed to do that. When Buddy gets that nomination, he has to give it a star. One, two, or three. One star means, hey, I was appreciated for doing my job. So Buddy might look at that nomination and say, what Jane did is exactly what she's supposed to do every day. She's doing it really well, and we want everybody to be doing it that way, so let's capture that as a success. I was told that some of you might not come back to the second session. Show of hands if you're not coming back. Young lady, you're not coming back? So I can count on the rest of you being here because it's going to be exciting.
Absolutely.
Okay. Thank you so much. Are you still with me?
Greg Lederman gave us a lot of valuable tools, which I'll be taking back with me and applying right away. It's been a very insightful and valuable session. It was well spent, the time we spent this morning.
Folks, thank you so much for having me here today. I really appreciate the opportunity to talk to you. Everyone, leave. Everybody's kind of sitting still. Really, that's it. It's over.